Okay, come now, let me see that.
Pranam Maharaj.
Okay.
Maharaj, many times, I asked you this yesterday also, many times you mention about this inquiry to find out who am I. And another thing is, when people ask you about suffering, you ask the other question, which is to find out who the sufferer is.
Yes.
And some of Maharaj's suffering and overcoming suffering seems to be a greater motivation than to find out who am I. So how to go about this?
Yes. This is a question from you directly. You want to, you're suffering, you want to know how to come out of suffering. How are you suffering?
Oh, Maharaj, ways more than one. The body, age, health, the impulses, the interaction,
yes,
the emotional pain, so many.
Pain is something actual, there's something actual about pain. Suffering is to do with an attitude towards pain. So pain is actual, suffering is optional. Pain is to do with something, even pain also, the way that pain is also interpreted depending upon how personal you are. Something can be painful, you say it's painful. Who can measure the pain? Someone can have some meter that measures, okay, we've gone up to 8 out of 10 here and he's still smiling. Okay? Another one has gone to 2 and he's kind of like, So can we look to the instrument to see how painful something is, or to the reaction to see how painful something is? You see? So the pain itself is to do with the, something to do with the one who pain is coming to. And that can be changed according to, if you are able to be detached also, the people that can be detached. Even a simple example, you know, and we're not using pain, but why not we can swap that. I had one nephew, and I used to, whenever I go to the house of my sister, I had this little play that I would grab him and tickle him. He would be like, sort of like 6-7 years old at the time. I used to grab him, you know, come on Nathan, come here, and I'd grab him, tickle, 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 tickle. And this is a little tradition we started, no? It went on every time I go there. So one time now, he was about 7 years old, and I said, come on, I'm going to tickle you. And he goes, stop, stop, stop. And I said, okay. He says, tickle me now, uncle. I said, suddenly it was not fun anymore. And I said, go on, tickle, 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 tickle. So I said, come here. And he was like, I said, this is very good. This is very good. It means you can do something with your attention. You can pull it away from the crime scene. And what did you do? What happened there? He said, I just became empty. So, same thing. Some people are able to somehow bring their attention away from where maybe the mind is going, oh, I'm going to be tickled, and oh, you're not going to be able to, it's going to be horrible, and so on. And we play along with that. So even pain, which is recognized as an actual thing, phenomenon, can be experienced in a different way. Suffering is another step from this also. I remember one conversation that happened in Mumbai some time ago, in the satsang of Sri Nisargadatta Maharaj, when the master was speaking, and someone said, sir, I am very much, your words are very powerful for me. But can I say something? If I must be honest, this man said, young man, if I must be honest, I must admit I am always experiencing suffering. So the master was very quick back. He says, no, that is not true. You are not experiencing suffering. You are suffering you're experiencing. You are not experiencing suffering. You are suffering you're experiencing. What did it mean? He made an option out of it. Suffering is not a thing. It is a state. You are not experiencing suffering. Your suffering, you're experiencing, which means that can change. If suffering was something, then everyone would suffer that something. He's saying the suffering you are suffering, you're experiencing, meaning that why are you suffering, you're experiencing, you see. So again now, relating to your question, you see, how can I end suffering? How can I come out, find out, I say, who the sufferer is? No, to you. Did you try to find out who the sufferer is? Can there be suffering without a sufferer?
No.
Yeah. So what is important for suffering is not just pain, but some identity must be there that says, no, I can't take this, it's too much, and so on, and so on, and so. An identity. Also, pain could come and someone, enough. And still, also, they can be, they didn't lose who they are to experience that. But so when I say, who exactly can the sufferer be identified? Is it possible? What did you do with that?
Yeah, usually it is something which I hold on to, yes. Some identity which I hold on to.
Yes. You who hold on to the identity is what? Slow down. You say, it is something that I hold on to it. That which you're calling I who hold on to the suffering or something, what is that I? Is that I stable? Is it reliable, this vice? No, open question.
No.
Is that I that says, you know, yes, I hold on to that, you know? I didn't hold on to the laughter and everything, but to the pain, I hold on to this sense of suffering, I hold on to it. I is what?
It's not a reliable one.
Not reliable one. Why?
Because it keeps changing my likes and dislikes also.
Yes, yes, yes. So what you can also say is something, obviously speaking like this, it is observed also. I call you on that one. You see, can you observe this or not? Can this be observed or not? And if it can be observed, what does it mean that you can observe something that you cannot be the thing you are observing? You cannot be the thing you're observing because they come and go, comes and goes out of your attention. If you are that thing, when it goes, you would also be gone. But you are here to say, ah, now it's gone. So you're not the thing you're observing. Yesterday I was pointing about self-awareness and I said that the great beginning is to start with the sense of being, that you know that you exist. You have a sense, the body's here, and you know you're conscious of this. Then I say, instead of putting the attention on the things coming up in the mind, the traffic of thoughts, sensations and so on, bring that to the sense of being. Please pay attention now. I'm going to surprise you a little bit. I say, bring it to the sense of being. Then you say, okay. And don't let it connect with other thoughts or anything at all. Just stay in the sense of being. And just like that, when followed, we begin to experience some sense of peace or expansiveness and a silence. The noise of the mind is not there. So we feel, thank you, thank you. I feel I am really just right here now. My beingness is right here. That's a very concentrated state. But I asked you just like this, and I'm saying now, whatever you can perceive is not your final truth. So even the sense of being itself, even the sense of being, the earliest manifestation arising from absoluteness. The sense I am and beingness are one. Even one's beingness is observable. If your very being, which is closer than intimacy, is observable, that which observes it is where and what? Has everybody fallen off the swinging bridge yet? This, I have not gone this way with you. Yes, I have, but not in this line. We shared the sense of being. Even if you are self-aware at the level of beingness, meaning that you're paying attention just to your own sense of existence, without story, without history, without relationship, without anything, just being alone externally and internally alone. You follow?
Yes.
Yes. That alone also will bring great peace and joy and contentment. Even love is beginning to flow here. But now, today, I'm saying, even if this is observable, what is observing this? Can that be seen? No. If it cannot be seen, how can we know it exists? The fact is helpful. The most subtle, the sense of being itself is perceived. That's fact. That's already a proof. There's something more subtle than even the sense of being. Don't try to think, oh, what is that? Because the mind will say, I'll help you. I'll show you. Your own private Google will come. I know what that is. No, you don't. It cannot be known in the classical sense. It cannot be known separate from you. There is no separation in it. That is the ultimate. That is the self. Ooh, grasp. Wow. Is it grasped merely as a kind of common sense, kind of like, yes, intellectually I understand this? Ah. Then in a way I could say you are found that which cannot be found. You have reached that which cannot be reached. You have seen and are in the seeing of that which cannot be seen. You are one with that which could never be two. And you, what about you?
Maharaj, it's just an intellectual understanding.
Yeah. Who says it's an intellectual understanding? Did the intellect say that's an intellectual understanding? Is not even intellect also observable?
Yes.
Is not even intelligence also perceived? Is not even the saying, this is an intellectual understanding, also perceived also?
Yes.
By what is it perceived? Even the thing that is saying, for me it's only an intellectual understanding, that is also perceived. The moment it is spoken, the breath that is speaking, that is also perceived also. And now it's blown away like a cloud also. Or it maybe still seem to be remaining because of memory and the importance given to that moment and that statement. Have I gone too far to say that? What about you? Yeah. What?
I'm following the train, Maharaj.
You're following?
The train of thoughts, what you're saying.
You're following the train of thoughts. Where are they going? Why are you following train of thoughts? Where are they going? You are the one watching train of thoughts to going, going, going. Are you going also?
No, I'm observing.
Then is it healthy to be following the train of thoughts? They're going by themselves, they're going. Even unforced, they're leaving, no? To make room for the next train coming, okay? Why you should be worried about it? Pay attention to yourself, what it means.
Just be the witness.
Is that an action that is to be taken?
No.
Witnessing is already there. Something is aware, yes, yes. My attention is moving, constantly going towards, you know, pursuing the thoughts, trying to work them out. Now I must stay just in the place of the witness. That's healthy for a while. Until what? What is the purpose? What's the value of witnessing? What is the value or purpose of witnessing something here in this context of the search for truth? It is only to confirm that all things witnessed and witnessable
are changing.
Are changing, isn't it? Whatever they may be, they are changing. You cannot maintain continuous, unbroken contact with anything. Even your favorite concept, you cannot do it. It's coming and going. Knowing that, leave it. It's going by itself. That's the first thing, that all things perceivable are moving along like clouds passing, waves flowing by, like that, no? Having seen that, no, like that, the energy returns to the source of the witnessing itself. You become aware of the environment of the witnessing itself. Because there's no further energy needs to be wasted paying attention to something that's constantly changing. So it comes back now, that which is witnessing all of this, no? Then you become aware, and this is right here. So you're not fragmented in your observation, jumping all over the place. Now you are at the very source where even witnessing is witnessed. Can I say like that even? That even the act or the functioning of perception is also perceived. Have you moved?
No. Yes, I can witness the witnessing.
Yes. At the point where the witness or the witnessing is perceived, who is there to know that? What is there? What can you say? Everything is spontaneously observed without effort. You wake up in the morning, did you have to switch on the senses? Eyes, ears, body. No, automatically they come into function, no? Automatically they come with the arising of consciousness, all the functions wake up altogether. What have you done? Did you switch on the lungs, breathing? No, everything is there already. What are you doing? Even observing aware of the functioning of the senses, the sense of time, everything is automatically there. Even the sense of doing something also appears also. In front of what? That which cannot be described. That is the supreme consciousness. Is it clear?
Yes, Maharaj.
Intellectually clear?
More than that.
More than that. Thank you. Thank you.